Hello, bonjour, futsak, salam, kami, banjingam. I'm from the Australian Government with a message for the world as we gather in Glasgow for this crucial climate summit. Fuck you. Over the coming days, our prime marketer will be there trying to shake a lot of hands and saying a lot of blah 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 like we're reducing emissions and net zero by 2050. But for those of you not fluent in Cantonese, the official language of the Australian government, what he's saying is, fuck you. We'll keep digging, burning and exporting fossil fuels, let you do the hard work and then take all the credit. Fick dick ins knee. We have lots of experience at this because that's what we do back home. We let the states and territories build renewables, subsidise EVs and retire coal plants, while we obstruct renewables, shit-talk EVs and subsidise coal plants, and then take credit for reducing emissions. We even take credit when those reductions are due to policies the opposition introduced when it was in office. Policies we scrapped, causing emissions to rise again. Sometimes we even take credit for things nobody does, like carbon credits for not clearing land that wasn't ever going to be cleared anyway. If a tree isn't cut down in a forest, does it make a sound? Why, yes. Cha-ching. All that might sound like we do nothing, but we're actually very busy. Our environment minister just opened 3 coal mines in a single month, whilst appealing a court ruling that she has a duty of care towards children over climate change. And our minister for emission reduction, yes, that's really his title, is supporting massive new gas projects that'll contribute a cubic shit ton of emissions to the world not meeting the Paris target. The equivalent of 46 more coal plants. That's 3 more than the 43 new coal plants China's planning to build. We really are overachievers. Or as you Italians might say, siamo dei gran stronzi. What's that? How can we be expanding fossil fuels now that we've announced net zero by 2050? Oh, sweetheart, we can precisely because of net zero by 2050. Does it come with a policy? Nope. Is it binding? Nope. Does it rely on technologies that work or even fucking exist? Nah. But does it distract from what we're doing this decade? You betcha. And don't think we're the only ones. Am I right, Norway? Nice huge gas exports you got there. Hey, Canada, America, loving that Line 3 pipeline you guys just expanded. UK, nice new oil rigs you got ready to go there in the North Sea. Russia, baby, we see you doing fuck all. And to all the other governments attending, we know you want to punch us in the face for obstructing every COP since Kyoto. But hey, as long as you keep buying our coal and gas exports, we know you secretly love us for it. Most Australians are profoundly ashamed of our climate shitfuckery, so don't blame them. Well, except the dickheads who keep voting for us. For them, we reserve our biggest fuck you of all with our technology, not taxes plan, which means you pay for bullshit technologies that greenwash fossil fuel companies and they keep paying no taxes. That's the Australian way. We hope you enjoy this summit. And if it fails, don't forget to thank Scotty from Coal Fondling and all of us here at the Australian Government. Allez-vous faire foutre? Aloi Gai. Iestash mai koyovi. Authorised by the Department for Blah Blah Blah.